In this video, I'm going to show you how to build your very own car that drives. First, you'll need a Build-A-Car kit from Tinian Tire Creations. It comes in both a boy and a girl model because girls love cars too. Inside your kit, you'll find everything you need to build your car, including some paint. First, we're going to start with our back wheel. We're going to attach the white gear and the orange stopper to the axle. Now note that this white gear is very important for this car to run. Without it, the car will not drive. Next, we're going to attach the rest of the wheels. I find that it's easier to put the pointy end of the axle on something hard as you push the wheel down. It's just easier on the fingers that way. This panel is what is going to hold our motor for the car. Make sure that big hole is right above the axle that we installed earlier. Now, you probably don't need glue, but sometimes some people do. So if you find it falling apart, then a little glue won't hurt. This is another important step to make sure your car drives. Attach the small white gear to the shaft of your motor. Next, you're going to attach the wires to the motor. Now, this is also a very important step of making the car work, because if you do not attach the wires to the battery case, which we'll talk about a little later, if the wires are not attached to the battery case and the motor on the right sides, then your car will drive backwards, and nobody wants a car that's driving backwards. So check the instruction manual in your kit, make sure you got it right. Next, we're going to insert the motor into the panel we installed earlier. Note that this will take a little bit of effort, so you have to push down firmly and wiggle it from side to side to get the motor in, but once it's in, it should slide down easily. Now, I'm going to slow down for a moment here because this is another important step. The gear you attach to the motor and the gear you attach to your axle must touch each other. They must be connected. If they are not, then your car will not drive. The motor will just keep spinning, but the car will not move. Those two gears need to be connected. Now we're going to attach the back of the car. Most people don't need glue, but if you find that this back keeps falling off, then you can use a little bit of glue to keep it secure. Next, attach one side of the car. Next, we're going to attach the hood or the bonnet of the car, whichever you prefer to call it, and then we're going to attach the roof. Now attach the other side of the car. Now we're going to attach the front or the bumper of the car. This plays a pretty important part in making sure your car stays together and doesn't fall apart. Next, we're going to attach the wheel, the spare wheel, to the back of the car. This allows the car to do a neat little trick. It allows the car to drive just on its back wheels. Now we're going to attach the wires to the battery case. Now remember what I mentioned earlier. You have to make sure that the wires are attached to the right side so that your car can drive forward instead of backwards. So if you find your car driving backwards, it's probably because you don't have the wires on the right side. So check the instruction manual in your kit to make sure that you've got it correct. Now attach the double-sided tape to your battery case. And then stick the battery case onto the top of your car. Your car is now complete, and all you need are 2 AA batteries. All right, let's see how this car drives. And there it goes. This is the part where it requires the wheel at the back of the car in order for it to do this little trick. I hope you enjoy your car, and don't forget to paint it.